Nice look from Jay by slamming Sam.
Wow! 3-point bump from the non-judgment.
We definitely have ourselves a ball game here.
What a contest going right around Australia on Fox.
Since the opening day of the season back in January, the Southeast Melbourne Magic have proven themselves to be the team to beat for this year's championship. And tonight the Sydney Kings are in town to put them to the test once more. Hello everybody, I'm John Casey. Welcome to Melbourne Park. We were here last night and saw the Cannons upset the Melbourne Tigers. Steve Carfino was along for the ride as usual, but Steve, for the Sydney Kings to repeat that dose here against the Magic, it's going to be a very big ask.
Well, it's a good game to get some good momentum coming off against the North Melbourne Giants. Gutsy come from behind win there. They were down by double figures most of the night. And if they're ever going to beat the Southeast Melbourne Magic, it's going to be tonight. They're probably down to 7 players. Clinton McDaniel is out with a groin injury. Andrew Parkinson is still out. Jason Smith suffered a shoulder injury against the Cannons on Wednesday, and so they're down.
And the Sydney Kings, as you mentioned, beating North Melbourne last night, no doubt that has them full of confidence. And as we get toward the business end, the Kings can't afford to drop too many more games.
And they're playing at full strength. The Sydney Kings, all they need to do is get on a roll and play some good basketball here against the Magic, the best team in the competition. They're down to seven guys. They don't have the depth. If they can pull this one out tonight, it'll be a huge win for them.
And Retro Week continues here. The players in their short shorts. One person who will be familiar with that is John Dorge, game number 350. He remembers playing in those shorts from years gone by.
Oh, that's right. He had some great performances in those shorts. 14 block shots. That's an NBL record. I don't think anybody's going to get that one. He should have a big game tonight.
And your tip?
The Sydney Kings. I think they're going to upset him.
Well, Steve Carfino puts his neck on the line. He says the Sydney Kings will prevail.
Well, not very often will I go against the Sydney Kings, but this is the night they have a chance to do it, coming off of a good come-from-behind win, getting a little bit of momentum going. That'll be a good chance for them to continue on what could be a very good weekend for them.
Yes, the Kings 102 defeated North Melbourne 98. They hit the lead with 3 minutes to go. That was the first time they were in front, and Evers Burns, 31 points, 16 rebounds, went a long way to helping the Kings over the line. The only other match last night, the Adelaide 36ers juggernaut continued. They defeated the Townsville Suns at the Furnace in Queensland, 117-105.
And we'd like to now get you to give a very special welcome to 5 past NBL champion players from the Nunawading Spectres and the St Kilda Saints, who have helped create the fabulous history of the National Basketball League. Having played with the Saints in 1985 and returned in 1991 to the Southern Melbourne Saints and then the Magic in 1992 and 93, please welcome onto the court guard Andre Lamanis. Also at guard, having played for Coburg in 1984, then the Eastside Spectres from 1988 to 89, NBL veteran guard, Paul Hutchin. From the United States of America, one of the sweetest shooting forwards ever to play out here for 6 seasons for the Nunawading and Eastside Spectres from 82 to 88, the 149 NBL game veteran, Ron Lemmers. The strong man of the Nunawading and Eastside Spectres for many, many years, commenced his long and distinguished playing career in the second season of the NBL in 1980, retiring as captain of the Eastside Melbourne Spectres in 89, having notched up 229 games. Please welcome forward Warren Pink. And finally, from the United States of America, the original captain of the Nunawading Spectres, who played over a 3-year period from the beginning of the NBL until 1981, when he was forced to retire through injury. You may know him as NBL Supremo, Bill Palmer. Looking good in those pants, Bill. Folks, please give it up for 5 past NBL champion players, all part of the history that you're now watching tonight.
Good to see the South East Melbourne Magic and their former players getting in the spirit of this retro week. I've seen other members of the front office at the NBL wearing clothes not dissimilar to that on a regular basis. Kevin Diggerson's name springs to mind.
Well, he's still got those retro glasses that he still wears.
Almost concluded here at Melbourne Park. The Australian Festival Singers doing the national anthem, and this is how the two teams are going to line up.
For the South East Melbourne Magic, they have a pretty big size guard backcourt with Mike Kelly and Frank Drimmick, and then Sam McKinnon's at the three spot, back from his NBA tryout playing at that Desert Classic camp. Tony Ronaldson will run at the four, and Brett Wheeler will be the five. That's a very strong starting five.
And for the Sydney Kings, Kelsey Weems, number six in the lead, averaging 23 points per game, top 10 in foul shooting and also assist. Shane Hill will wear the number 23 singlet. Matty Nilsson, the reigning Rookie of the Year. Scott McGregor, Rookie of the Year from 1996. And Evers Burns, I mentioned his numbers last night. He certainly has been a significant contributor for the Sydney Kings since arriving here in Australia.
And the bench's Jason Smith will suit up. He didn't look like that shoulder was bothering him much in warm-ups. Ben Knight will get a run, the young kid from Penrith in New South Wales. And John Dorge suits up for the first time since the second game.
And for the Sydney Kings, Brad Rosen, Stephen Whitehead starred for the Kings in their last quarter revival last night against North Melbourne. He had 15 in the quarter, 21 for the game of season high. Aaron Trehair, who played very well against the Magic earlier in the season, where he top scored for the Kings with 20, although the Magic won it convincingly by 27. Brad Williams and Bruce Bolden, averaging 10 points per game off the bench against his former team that he captained to the championship back in 1992. Eddie Crouch, Alan Godden, Scott Cogley, our referees, all wearing the Fox microphones to take you right inside the action. And we are underway at Melbourne Park, and the South East Melbourne Magic, the men in black, come up with the opening possession. Played well against the Cannons here on Wednesday night. Tony Ronaldson misses with the opening shot. Evers Burns the rebound. Quick outlet pass to Kelsey Weems. He fires over the top of Mike Kelly, and looking confident, Kelsey Weems gets us underway.
And that's going to be something that the Sydney Kings will look to do, run the break and have those guards, those quick guards, explore their options on the break.
Ronaldson lost the handle on it. Now he's wrestling with McGregor for it. Retrieve the situation. Now Wheeler moves on to Mike Kelly. Against Burns, fires from three-point territory. Hard on the iron. He's going to get his own rebound. Here's Frank Drimmick, the star of the past four games for the South East Melbourne Magic. And now Weems has relieved Kelly of possession. Hill, working against Frank Drimmick, his Australian squad teammate. And Shane Hill hasn't had a lot of calls go his way in recent weeks, but he draws the first foul of the match on Frank Drimmick.
Well, Frank did a good job of staying in the passing lane and making Shane Hill finish that play and not just flip it over to Kelsey Weems, and a missed free throw from Shane Hill. You won't see that very often. Interesting to see if the Sydney Kings pressure the Southeast Melbourne Magic with Clinton McDaniel out. They really don't have a great ball handler in the backcourt for the Magic. Let's see if the Kings at any time will extend the pressure.
Shane Hill has missed only nine foul shots from 73 attempts all year. He's missed two in a row. Here's Drimmick, couldn't get it to go, has his own rebound, working against Burns, the tip in from Brett Wheeler.
And that's the flip side of the advantage that the Magic have.
with those big guards, Frank Drimmick and Mike Kelly, they'll have the ability to post up those two smaller Sydney Kings guards.
And home!
McGregor top of the key, guarded by Drimmick. Now Kelsey Williams, here comes Shane Hill. Didn't have a good shooting night last evening against North Melbourne. His team still won, however. And McGregor, his opening shot is all nylon. Penetrating Mackinnon from close range. The Kings give up more points than any other team in the NBL. 105 at the moment. And they're going to have to play pretty tight against a Magic team. But while down in numbers, Steve, they do have quality. Hill works his way to the hoop. It was an off-bounce shot. Again, one shot. Again, wanting a whistle, none forthcoming. But he'll take the two anyway. Kings really need to have all five on the court playing defense, Steve, against this team. Every one of their starting five is capable of getting 20 or more. This is Kelly, short on the iron. Burns with the rebound. Off to Weems. Heard Mike Kelly coming. He wouldn't have been able to see him. He penetrates, dishes to Nielsen. Now Shane Hill inside Kelly. Retreats away from Drimmick and now dishes to Evers Burns. Nielsen down to the baseline against Mike Kelly. Can't exploit his height advantage. He moves the ball back to Shane Hill. Shot clock now into single figures for the Sydney Kings. Weems wrestling with Mackinnon. Has to pull the trigger with a shot clock expiring. Weems finds the target for three. Kings 4 of 4 from the field. They lead it by five.
It's all right.
Well, the young Crocs going at it there. Sam Mackinnon and Matty Nielsen. Sam a pretty hard foul, but it wasn't going to let Sam get upstairs and go up for the jam. The Sydney Kings really got bailed out by a very tough shot by Kelsey Weems on that with a shot clock winding down. Look at that rainbow he has to shoot over the Magic defender. And that's just very good defense from the Magic, and they have the ability to do that for that whole possession. The Sydney Kings didn't look like they were ever going to get a shot off.
Sam 3 minutes played here, opening quarter from Melbourne Park, and the Kings lead by three as Weems comes forward. Didn't play when these sides met back in March. A different looking Sydney Kings outfit who are on the edge of the six at the moment. A victory here may force them into the top echelon depending on other results. The Melbourne Tigers are in Perth tonight, and the Brisbane Bullets journey to Newcastle in a must-win game for them to try and stop their slide. Here's Wheeler off the glass, hit it too hard, and Burns came up with the rebound. Weems fires over Mike Kelly. This time it's all oxygen. It was a pass to McGregor, who now goes to Shane Hill. Second opportunity here for the Kings. Shane Hill against Mackinnon goes to Nielsen. He gets it back. Works to the left-hand side. No room for the shot there either, but under the bucket is Evers Burns from close range. He makes it fit. Lost a shoe in the process.
I hope he's going to retie that. Obviously, it wasn't tied up tight enough if it slipped off like that. You don't see that too often. And you definitely don't want that to happen to you when you're on the defensive end of the floor. Guy makes a good move on you, then the word around the league is
going to help the tie up,
fake you out of your shoes.
Levis Burns is in no hurry here. Retying the right boot. What a tremendous pickup he has been for the Sydney Kings. He made his debut here in the NBL against the Southeast Melbourne Magic back on the 11th of March, and has improved with every match he has played. Caught a glimpse of some of the retro crowd in here at Melbourne Park, getting in the spirit of the 20th anniversary celebrations of the NBL. Mackinnon from the foul line, couldn't get it to go. Burns comes up with the ball, releases Weems with speed to Shane Hill. Back to Weems, awkward pass. It spills out of court. Sydney will maintain possession. Matt Nielsen will restart proceedings. Kelsey Weems being guarded by Ronaldson at the moment. Magic just having trouble finding the Kings at the moment, and that left Evers Burns open from the foul line. He connects. 2 of 2 from the field. The lead is now 7, the biggest in the match so far.
Well, Evers can pop that little medium range J. The Magic are so conscious of being in that help defense. That's a shot that's going to be open.
On his third attempt, Mike Kelly eventually finds the target. He top scored and was MVP when these sides met back in March. Weems couldn't get the user-friendly roll. Now Drimmick comes up with it to Kelly. He's wide open again. This time he overshoots the ball. Sam Mackinnon had better position than Nielsen, but couldn't finish it off. Wheeler can. Helped in by Mackinnon. Second and third opportunities here for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Kings need to keep them off the offensive glass. Burns looking for Nielsen. Needed two attempts to reel it in. Now has to go back to Scotty McGregor. Burns on the baseline, fires with the left hand. Nielsen keeps it alive, but it spills out of court. And the Magic are going to come up with possession. 5.5 minutes played. Kings 13, lead the Magic 10, who have scored the last 4 points.
Well, I know that Shane Heal and Kelsey Weems play a lot of minutes for the Sydney Kings, but the Kings have a full roster over there. They've got Aaron Trahair on the bench. They've got Brad Williams, they've got Stephen Whitehead, they've got a whole lot of guys that they can go to. With the Magic down on numbers, I'd be throwing a lot of pressure at them.
Here's Drimmick from close range. He kisses two off the glass. First points in the match for Drimmick. He had 28 at his last start against Canberra here on Wednesday, and a career-high 31. Here he is again with it. That 31 came against Newcastle, which we had here on Fox.
10 to push. Up here, sub.
Foul called on Scotty McGregor, second for the Sydney Kings. One team foul on the Magic at the moment.
You see, with no pressure, the Magic just allowed to run their offense and just run the basic drill, their basic drills.
And Ronaldson connects from downtown. He puts the Southeast Melbourne Magic in front for the first time in the match. They have now scored 9 unanswered points. Bolden checks into the game and looking to have an impact. Tosses the ball out of court. Turnover for the Sydney Kings. Their second.
Well, Bruce Bolden checking in. That's one of the Sydney Kings subs. But well, the Magic, you can't think that they're not going to make any mistakes with no pressure on them. They're the best team in the competition.
Here's Drimmick trying to post up the smaller Shane Hill, who can't prevent him from getting the shot away. It skipped over the cylinder. Now Bolden looking for Hill. Drimmick's got it back with Kelly in support. An easy two. The Magic have now scored the last 11 points of the match in a 2-minute spurt that has turned this around here in the opening turn. Hill a long way from the hoop, being guarded by Sam Mackinnon. Uses Kelsey Weems, is guarded by Mike Kelly. Penetrating, spinning to the baseline. Excellent move from Kelsey Weems, showing his class.
Well, he can do that. He can get to the hole. And they've just got to keep it spread out for him.
Kelly looking for the offensive rebound. Burns had it. Wheeler took it away from him, and now Kelly's got it back again. From close range without success, Nielsen comes up with the rebound, dribbling in traffic. Now Hill firing over the top of Sam Mackinnon. He makes three more.
What a tough shot. Good defense by Sam Mackinnon. Normally you tell a guy if he has to shoot a three with that much pressure on the break not to shoot it. Frank Drimmick answers with a bomb of his own. He's been in great form. He loves to play in front of the television cameras.
Here's Nielsen being monstered by Drimmick from behind. Ronaldson from the front. He's going to the stripe. Foul is going to be called on Frank Drimmick. That will be his second personal.
Let's go.
Substitution for the Magic.
Well, Frank Drimmick has had his 4 career highs this year on television. And the last one, of course, was in Newcastle, where he had 31 points on 8 of 11 shooting from outside the arc.
Rookie of the year last season, Matt Nielsen, can't put the finishing touches on the second foul shot. 4 minutes remain here in the opening quarter. The Magic lead it by a single point after being down by as much as 7. As Kelly fires away over Bolden. Couldn't get it to go. George back in for his first shot in game number 350. He celebrates in style. Kelly's got a steal. Off Mackinnon looking for a dunk. Matty Nielsen prevents that, but sends Mackinnon back to the stripe.
Just great anticipation by Mike Kelly.
Look at that, just a careless play by both Maddie Nielsen and Kelsey Weems, going the wrong way, not aware of the defense. Really, it's the passer's responsibility to give him a little fake if there's somebody's close enough to him to get a steal. And let's see what the Sydney Kings respond with the magic charge.
Sam Mackinnon. Mackinnon now has 8 points in the match to lead the game. Magic enjoying a five-point break. Took over 3.5 minutes remaining here. Term number one from Melbourne Park. Week 14 of the NBL as Bolden fires and connects. Bruce Bolden has done this game in, game out this year, off the bench and immediately having an impact, connecting his opening shot.
Well, Bruce Bolden will give John Dorge lots to worry about at the high post. The big fella is not a great perimeter defender.
Ronaldson against McGregor, now Sam Mackinnon. Down low, Drimmick. Nielsen double-teaming him with Shane Hill. It spills out of court, 11 seconds on the shot clock. Magic have lost only three games all year, two of those by 5 points, and a 20-point drubbing, in fact 22, at the hands of the Perth Wildcats back on the 2nd of April. Mackinnon, surprised to find himself so open, then couldn't connect on the shot, and Bolden comes up with a rebound. A couple of points, a couple of rebounds already for Bruce Bolden. As Shane Hill penetrates, high off the window without success, he gets it back. Whistle provided. Now a foul has been called on Bruce Bolden. That will be his first personal. And the Magic front office staff getting involved in this retro week theme as well. Shane Hill has stated that if the Kings were to win both their games this weekend, he would wear the short shorts for the rest of the year. Kings 1-0 after beating North Melbourne last night. Here's Kelly spinning on the baseline. Tough shot, couldn't get it to go, but Dorge is there to clean it up. 350th game for John Dorge, but it's taken him 2 years to play the last 50. Heavy contact off the ball as Kelly and Bruce Bolden crash to the floor. And foul is called on Mike Kelly.
Well, you can see on the replay, Bruce trying to shove him off. Mike Kelly didn't like that knock, just pulled him down with him. And Mike Kelly, I thought for a second it was going to be a double foul, but Mike Kelly gets the intentional foul and go to the line for two in the possession.
What a tremendous player Bruce Bolden has been. Not only for the Kings, but for the Magic prior to that. Spent some time in the CBA in the States and also played in Norway before arriving in Australia in 1987, his 12th year in the NBL. 2:22 left on the clock here. Kings are going to come up with possession as well. They've closed to within four.
That 4-point difference has been on the free throw line. Kings just 2 of 6. Magic, a perfect 4 for 4.
Hill, 5 points in the match. Connected on his only attempt from outside the arc. The no-look pass ends up in the crowd. Much to the delight of the home fans. Magic in action again here on Wednesday against the Illawarra Hawks, who are in the six at the moment and keep confounding the critics by winning continually. Kelly down low had some space to work into, but the pass was a little off the mark, and that resulted in the missed shot, and now Bolden draws a foul on Sam Mackinnon. That will be his first personal, and Bruce Bolden will go back to the stripe.
And right now the Kings, it's going in their favor right now. A couple of the Magic players getting a little bit worried about that exchange with Mike Kelly. John Dorge having a few words. Brian Gorgon didn't like that last call. Felt like Mike Kelly was hit on the arm. And Magic just need to get back to playing this game their style.
Stephen Whitehead has checked into the game, wearing number 8 for the Sydney Kings. He's a former Melbourne boy, having won a championship with the Tigers. Bolden edges the Kings back to within 2 here And we have a minute 45 remaining in the opening quarter. NBL live around Australia. Fox Sports 2. Don't forget the NBA action tomorrow on Fox Sports from midday. The decider between Minnesota and Seattle. And Tony Ronaldson is feeling it tonight. 2 of 3 from beyond the perimeter for his 6 points. The lead is back to 5 in favor of the Magic. Bolden. He too is on fire. Early stages of this match. 7 points off the bench for Bruce Bolden. Only Sam Mackinnon with 8 has more in the match.
And that's going to trouble the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Bruce Bolden, 18 feet away from the basket. John Dorge just can't get out there in time.
Mike Kelly is 2 of 9 from the field at the moment. Can't get a shot away on that occasion. Murray out of position, Murray out of position. Here's Weems, confronted by Ronaldson, who did a good job. It spills to Whitehead, losing balance. He fires the ball to Bolden, and Bruce Bolden puts it in the hole. The Kings are back to within 1.
And that's exactly the hustle plays that they need, especially from players coming off the bench, injecting a little bit of enthusiasm into the lineup.
Jason Smith being guarded by Shane Hill, penetrating. Now Kelly couldn't get past Weems, and Scotty McGregor gets a piece of the ball. It spills out of court. 13 seconds on the shot clock for the Magic. 13 on the shot. Billy Tomlinson, coach of the Kings, an up-and-down season for him. This is Ronaldson from three-point territory. McGregor got a piece of it and is now in the open court. If Hill can find him, he does so. Bolden lost it initially and then missed the shot, and Dorge came up with the rebound. Jason Smith, two-point attempt, hard on the iron. Mackinnon over the top of Shane Hill. Stand by! Jason Smith puts an exclamation point on that play. She rises above the rim.
I don't think Kelsey Weems, yeah, he does know how much time's left.
Pulls up for the J, couldn't get it to go, and Tony Ronaldson puts a finish to term number 1 here at Melbourne Park. And after being down by as much as 7, the Southeast Melbourne Magic find themselves in front by 3, the Magic 31, Sydney 28, here on Fox.
Well, the good teams, they can win when they don't shoot a great percentage. Southeast Melbourne Magic on top by 3 points. Only shooting 40% from the field, but look at those second effort shots like that. Good rebound by Sam Mackinnon. Shane Hill was just overmatched. He went right over the top of him to get that rebound, then to get it to Jason Smith. They've taken 30 shots of Southeast Melbourne Magic to the Sydney Kings 19.
There is the ladder as it stands at the moment, and as you can see, the Kings just on the fringe there. A victory here will push them up to the top 6, level with the Canberra Cannons. And as we mentioned last night, Steve, the Magic and Adelaide have opened up a break, and the Falcons and the Giants down the bottom, well, after losing last night, North Melbourne are effectively out of the race. And the remaining teams, from the Wildcats down to the Suns, are all wrestling for that last playoff spot, although Townsville losing to Adelaide last night means that they have to win probably 6 of their last 7. That may be beyond them, Steve.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. Those people at the bottom are definitely going to have to make a run.
Make their defense shift. Steve and Shane, just cut the wings, just move. But make sure we get 2 reversals, then we're coming inside, high-low. If the ball comes into the block, the opposite post, you've got to get to the foul line. That's where it's open, right there. And see that. You're trying to pass through the muscle all the time, right? Fellas, just get the checkouts down. Don't give them a second shot. Look after the ball, and right there, we want to be.
And that's a couple of good points. The high post is the area the Sydney Kings have been doing very well in the attack. They're down by 3. It's the shooting percentage that is amazing. 12 of 30 shot attempts for the Southeast Melbourne Magic to the Sydney Kings, 11 of 19 at 57, still down 3. Free throws, perfect 4 for 4 for the Magic, 4 of 8 for the Kings. 3-point shooting, the Kings are 2 of 3. Turnovers, only 2 for the Magic. Assists are pretty close, and the rebounding going to the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Top scorer, Sam Mackinnon. He's been active on the glass, and he has 8 points. Ronaldson with 6 for the Sydney Kings. Their top scorers are Bruce Bolden coming off the bench for 9, and Kelsey Weems with 7.
Halftime at Newcastle, and 19 points from Steve Woodbury has the Brisbane Bullets in front by 3 at the major break. Brisbane 43, lead Newcastle 40. Here at Melbourne Park, Tony Ronaldson looking to extend the Southeast Melbourne Magic's lead. He couldn't, but Mackinnon can. And we now have a five-point break in favour of the Magic. Just getting their points a little too easy for my liking, Steve. Kings do score a lot, but they would need to be a little tighter on the Magic when they're playing D.
Offensive foul.
I've got it. It's Brett.
Fouls on Evers Burns.
Evers Burns is called for an offensive foul. They turn the ball over again. Burns has struggled in that department, Steve. He averages four fouls per game to be third in the league. He fouled out last night against the North Melbourne Giants with 90 seconds remaining. And, of course, when we did their last match against Canberra, he was shuffled in and out of the lineup because of foul problems early in the game. This is Ronaldson against Bolden, his former teammate, his former captain, incidentally, as Wheeler coming in strongly. Look to be in the vicinity. Believe it or not, there are more of the Magic hierarchy, front office staff. Incognito, is that George Fisk there with the guitar? I just wonder.
Well, he's got to take first prize. I thought that was the 60s. We going back that far?
I don't know, Steve, I wasn't around. Again, a whistle off the ball, and the same call has been made on Evers Burns, I believe. Another foul for use of the elbow. And that is his second personal in the space of 60 seconds.
Well, he's got to adjust. He had six fouls with 4 minutes to go in the game last night against North Melbourne. He was absolutely killing the Giants. So he has got to take a responsibility to his team to get out, stay out of foul trouble.
And a whistle off the ball, and Stephen Whitehead is the victim on this occasion. Restricting the movement of Sam Mackinnon. He doesn't like the call.
See now, Case, it was the Southeast Melbourne Magic worrying about the calls a few minutes ago, and the Sydney Kings made a bit of a run.
I'm just saying, be careful.
And now it's the Sydney Kings worrying about the calls, and the Southeast Melbourne Magic are just steady building on that lead.
Stay focused right now. We're here to do a job. Let's get our job done, what we've got to do. Get the ball reversed, and then we can run the push. We can run the push with anyone here. We're still trying to come in against the muscle all the time. Get the ball reversed. Just come down, three out, two in, get the kick, then run the push.
Hey, the thing is, though, don't let them deny it.
Keep that action going, all right? Now, we're looking at Sam on the inbounds play here, into motion, all right? Real good job. Stay with it now. Just got to play that D, baby. Magic. Here we go. Magic. Let's go.
Brian Gorgian, coach of the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Arguably the most successful coach in the league percentage-wise. Has been around for some time. 218 wins for Brian Gorgian. 99 defeats. Is that the same man? A very young-looking Brian Gorgian. I'm surprised Steve Carfino is chuckling after we saw him last evening.
I'm just laughing at the fact that he watched the game last night and he had plenty to say about you and I, how we looked 10 years ago. But, man, nice fro.
I'm sure Brian will enjoy that when he's using the tape for scouting purposes during the week. Here come the Sydney Kings. Let's see if they can get their minds back on the job. We've played 90 seconds of term number two. They trail by five, yet to add to their quarter time tally. Burns is blocked by Ronaldson, trying to muscle his way to the hoop. His strength was matched by that of Tony Ronaldson. He comes up empty. Mackinnon back to Ronaldson. And now Wheeler with a height advantage over Burns. He goes to the non-preferred right hand, couldn't get it to go, and another foul is going to be called on Stephen Whitehead. At the moment, the Magic just a little too athletic for the Kings and getting lots of offensive rebounds. Would you believe they have 12 already in the match? The Kings have two offensive rebounds. Most teams average around 12 to 14. The Magic just killing Sydney and getting second and third opportunities. And here's Wheeler close to the hoop. Bold and lucky not to be called for the foul, but Wheeler finds the target. And the lead now is out to seven. We heard the call from Eddie Crouch, carrying violation against Kelsey Weems.
And the Kings will get a warning. See the ball gets stuck on his hip right there. That's a good call. I mean, the ball gets stuck on his hip. If he was pushed, that'd be one thing. or shoved into making that mistake, but the ball stuck on his hip and he was gaining ground as the ball was on his hips. Either that or a travel. Take your pick.
Kings turn the ball over for the eighth time. As you can see, the Magic much better in that area, although Kelly almost throws it away. Working against Weems. Mr. Fix-It, they called Mike Kelly, with Clint McDaniel out injured for some time and with Billy McCaffrey yet to arrive as his replacement. Kelly doing the ball-carrying duties. This is Jason Smith firing from long range. And finally, the Kings get on the boards as a team. Weems wants Shane Hill on the right wing and gets him against Jason Smith. Now Burns beyond his range with Ronaldson guarding him out at the perimeter. Working baseline, Shane Hill draws a foul on Brett Wheeler, who was just trying to shepherd him out of court. That will be Brett Wheeler's second personal.
Well, Shane Hill going baseline, he really wanted the basketball, leading out for it a couple of times. Jason Smith, very good defender on him.
Shane Hill, catch and shoot from the inbound pass. Drimmick has checked into the game for Brett Wheeler, comes up with the rebound. Alley-oop player, Smith! Well, these exciting youngsters from the Southeast Melbourne Magic bring the fans alive. Lead out to 9, the biggest we've seen. There's not much the Kings can do to prevent that from happening. They're playing quite a different game to 20 years ago when the NBL started, Steve. This is retro week, and when you think back to the way the game was played then, I don't know that the alley-oop was in vogue.
Well, you could throw the pass 10 years ago, but nobody would go upstairs like that and catch it, much less dunk it. It's an unbelievable change, the athleticism of these young kids coming in the game now.
Not bad for the league's best three-point shooter either to be getting upstairs like that. Jason Smith is certainly one of the best young talents in this country. Here he is guarding Shane Hill. Now Nilsson against Drimmick. Takes him on, works to the baseline and finds the target. Matty Nilsson comes up with his first field goal. Eases the situation somewhat for the Kings, but they would not like the Magic to get too much further away from them. This is Ronaldson looking for a triple. Couldn't get it to go. Again, Whitehead using his body to keep Mackinnon out of the play. This time legally, according to the referees. And Shane Hill brings the Kings up the floor. Burns, fall away jump shot. Nilsson keeps it alive. Did that well to Kelsey Weems. He fires over Kelly. Did everything but fall. Nilsson tries the same play. This time Jason Smith was awake to it. Kelly got past Kelsey Weems pretty easily and then put the finishing touches on. Weems up the floor. Here's Whitehead working against Mackinnon. Follow-away jump shot. He was forced into a tough shot. Nilsson came up with the offensive rebound. Mike Kelly will be called for his second personal foul.
Well, the Magic don't let you do anything easy. Stephen Whitehead looked open, and as he started to get that ball into the shooting pocket, the Southeast Melbourne Magic put the heat on that shot. He had to fall away and put a lot of arch on it, and that's why it's very difficult to continue to shoot a high percentage against the Magic, because as the game goes on, they get tougher.
Yeah, wrong man.
4.5 minutes played, term number two. The Southeast Melbourne Magic have a 9-point edge after leading by 3 at quarter time. Kings have added only 2 points in the first 4.5 minutes. Into the game. Dishes off to Hill, who goes to Burns. Thinking about the jam. His path to the hoop was blocked by Jason Smith. And now at the other end, Tony Ronaldson, if he can reel this in, should get an easy layup. Suggestion of travel in there as well. Now Weems wants to take them on. He shows them some speed. And that is good news for the Sydney Kings.
That was a tremendous move by Kelsey Weems. Full speed with a nice crossover.
Smith close to the hoop is fouled from behind, and Evers Burns has picked up foul number 3.
Number 9. Hands on the head. Got 2.
Well, Jason Smith was going up for the left-hand jam there. Evers Burns gave him a nice hard whack across the side of the head.
Here to go.
And it won't be long before Evers Burns has to take a seat with his 4th foul at the rate that he's going. playing very aggressively.
Jason Smith has missed only five foul shots all season. Calmly ices two here, and the lead is into double figures for the first time in the match. Tick under 7 minutes away from the major break. Trahair works the ball to the top of the key. Nilsson onward to Kelsey Weems, being guarded by Kelly. Now Trahair and Shane Hill a long way from the hoop with a shot clock down into single figures. He takes Jason Smith on from the foul line. Couldn't get it to go. It's loose. Ronaldson had it. Spills out of court off his knee. And the Kings will get a new 30-second shot clock.
And that's another tough shot the Sydney Kings are forced into from the Southeast Melbourne Magic swarming defense.
Trahair. Yeah, take a shot in the match. Now Nilsson a long way from the hoop, but he's equal to the challenge. Despite some good D from Frank Drimmick, Nilsson drains two.
Now the Magic just allowed to bring the basketball up the court. They don't have a whole lot of guys. I would think you try and get these guys tired so they can wear them down and take some of that pressure off that they put on you defensively.
Kelly plants his feet, fires for three. Nilsson has the rebound. Off to Weems. No teammates ahead of him for the moment, but he's still going forward and drawing a foul on the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Drimmick and or Mike Kelly. It's going to be on Mike Kelly. That will be his third personal. So he, like Evers Burns, in something of foul trouble here with almost 6 minutes still to play in term number two. And both Burns and Kelly are going to sit down here. Timeout has been called. And it is the Southeast Melbourne Magic with a 9-point break. 5:56 on the clock. It's all halftime. It's all halftime. Southeast Melbourne Magic pride themselves on putting on some very good entertainment throughout the match. Certainly the girls dancing up a treat there.
And I'd say the Southeast Melbourne Magic also take pride in playing some good basketball too. You have to consider the big loss that Clinton McDaniel poses for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. He's their primary ball handler. He's the guy that guards any quick scoring guard that the Magic play against, and they're without him. Their leading scorer, good three-point shooter, and a very solid defender, and the guy on the team that has a bit of moxie and a bit of city in him gives them a bit of jazz, and they're missing that, and they're still just cruising along like nothing's wrong. I made a little mistake with Jason Smith. I'm just going on what Brian Gorgian said at the shoot around. He said he probably wouldn't do much because of that shoulder. But John Dorge hasn't played since the second game of the season. So they're virtually playing with seven guys. And they are still putting all the pressure on the Sydney Kings.
They've been doing it effectively as well. They basically have had injury problems since day one as Mackinnon goes to work against Trahair. Couldn't get it to fit. Body foul is being found on the Sydney Kings.
4-0.
Bruce Bolden has been called for his second personal. And Steve, the point I was going to ask you is, do the teams need a 10-man roster? The Magic have been able to do it with eight, perhaps to share some of the more quality players around the league if they were to reduce the benches.
Well, I think that a good team, usually only uses about 7-8 guys. And then the other guys are there for training or if somebody gets injured. It's very hard to rotate 10 guys in a 48-minute game. you want your best players out of court for the maximum amount of minutes due to their fitness.
Williams has lost the handle. It spills to Jason Smith. And the Southeast Melbourne Magic come forward. Firing Drimmick without success. Gets his own rebound. Now that's a bad mistake from the Sydney Kings. And Brett Wheeler makes them pay. When the Magic make it so hard for a team to score, that means that they have to be vigilant on loose balls, offensive rebounds and the like. And the Kings were caught napping there. And it cost them 2 points. Here's Bolden spinning to the baseline over Brett Wheeler. Couldn't get it to go. Well, that's an unusual move, but effective from Aaron Trahair. He puts the ball back up without coming down. And Aaron Trahair has his first points in the match. Tick under 5 minutes out from halftime. 7-point edge to the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Explanation from Eddie Crouch to Aaron Trahair. His first personal.
Well, the Magic are going to do that. If the Kings aren't going to put any kind of a pressure on the Magic getting the ball up the court, they're just going to come down, take their time, and take advantage of those mismatches that they have on the smaller Sydney Kings guards.
Sam Mackinnon averages 12 points per game. He's been in the 20s only twice this year. But while his points production is down from last season, almost every other category he has improved in. Averaging 7 rebounds, top 10 in the league with 5 assists, top 10 in the league with a couple of steals per game. He's leaving the scoring to others. And Aaron Trahair, this time with a left hand, couldn't get it to go. Bolden in traffic, banks 2 off the glass. Bolden is now into double figures. He joins Sam Mackinnon and Kelsey Weems with 11 as the game high scorer. Drimmick trying to exploit his high advantage against Shane Hill. And the foul is called on the Sydney Kings guard.
Now there have been 20 fouls called in this game, make that 21. And this game is being played at a very physical pace. I mean, they're calling lots of fouls, but still these guys are shoving and really getting good knocks as they're going up for the shots, and some of them are no calls. And it seems like every time somebody goes up for an inside shot, they're getting clobbered. They can't call every foul. And I think that if the game continues to be played at that pace, that physical, it'll go to the Magic.
Williams just colliding with Sam Mackinnon. See, this play phase underway. These teams working on the Andrew Vlahov rule of no blood, no foul. Here's Bolden skipping his way into the paint. Couldn't get it to fall, but has drawn a foul. Whistle provided by Alan Godden. One also provided by Eddie Crouch.
There's nothing there on you. He's caught it. He's got a good view of it. He's got you. 2 shots to Bruce
Bolden. Bolden goes to the stripe. Foul has been called on Brett Wheeler. That will be his third personal. Drimmick and Kelly also on that number. It was Burns, likewise, for the Sydney Kings. Bolden now leads the game in scoring, has 4 rebounds as well.
They're saying Jason Smith, did you see? I'm not 100% positive it was on.
It was me. Who did you make it on?
I caught on Wheeler.
Brett wasn't in the play. Brett wasn't in the play. He was away. He called on Brett. He wasn't in the play at all.
It would appear the foul is now going to be attributed to Jason Smith. Smith was quick to put his hand up.
He wasn't close to him.
That was his first foul. It eases their situation dramatically. Because if Wheeler had 3 to go with Kelly's 3, might have made things just a little bit tight for the Magic. Less than 4 minutes out from halftime, Kings back to within 6. They need a stop. Found it hard to stop the Magic so far. From long range, Drimmick without success. Bolden did well there against Tony Ronaldson. Now Weems gets past Jason Smith pretty easily. Outside, Trahair is the danger, and he buries it.
And that's when the Sydney Kings look extremely tough. Kelsey Weems has the ability to push the ball through traffic and get it to those shooters. One on each side, Shane Hill and Aaron Trahair.
Back to a 3-point game. After trailing by 11 just 3 minutes ago, the Kings are starting to close. Drimmick bodies Shane Hill out of the equation and helps himself for two more. He is now up to nine to go with four rebounds. And again, Weems wants to take Smith on, and Jason Smith has his second personal.
10 to push. We got two.
Just seeing both of these teams going to their strengths now. Kelsey Weems taking the magic off the dribble, trying to spread out. Trying to spread out the magic. There he is there, and then it's pretty obvious that Jason Smith's putting the body on Kelsey Weems. Really no choice other than to give him the foul. On the other end, the magic posting up those smaller guards. Frank Drimmick hits a turnaround shot on Shane Hill.
Weems 89% from the free throw line, number 7 in the league coming into this match. 3 of 3 at the moment. And I've talked him into a miss. Wheeler comes up with the rebound. 4-point break in favour of the Magic as we count down the final 3 minutes of the opening half from Melbourne Park. Kings 9 of 14 from the stripe, Magic 9 of 12. Here's Wheeler. Against Nilsson, shows him the ball inside Drimmick. Too tall for Shane Hill. He short-armed the shot, however, and came up empty. Now Nilsson wants to take Drimmick on. Hill is a more likely conveyance, carrying the ball. Jason Smith has now switched onto him, and Mackinnon will try and guard the lightning-quick Weems. With Trehear, Kings running a three-guard rotation. One of their big men is Nilsson from close range. He has the Sydney Kings back to within a single bucket.
Good recognition by Shane Hill. He knew both guys came out on that screen, and Matty Nilsson did a good job of getting to the open area, going to the basket.
Ronaldson against Bruce Bolden, backing his way in closer to the hoop, did a lap of honor and wouldn't fall, and now Weems is fouled from behind, a cheap one on Jason Smith. And that is his third personal foul. So after having none 2 minutes ago, put his hand up for one, and they've given him three.
And those are the calls that were going unchecked several minutes ago, and it just looks like the referees have just cranked it up a little bit, making those calls, and they've got a better hold on the game. Not nearly as much complaining, even though there have been more fouls called. I think the players will start to adjust to how this game is being called now.
Let's go! Hey! Here it comes! Come on!
Kelsey Weems with an opportunity here to tie the ball game away. Kings have finished term number two here very strongly. And Weems does just that. He now has 14 points to lead the game. Sam Mackinnon. Now Wheeler, looking around the perimeter, looking for Kelly, but Weems denies the ball to him. This is Tony Ronaldson firing. Couldn't get it to go. Wheeler has another offensive rebound.
Watch the hold.
And the foul has been called on the Sydney Kings. Matt Nilsson in the vicinity. That is his third personal.
Well, Matty Nilsson was called for leaning back into Brett Wheeler. As he pulled down that board, Matty Nilsson was just leaning back, trying to affect the shot of Wheeler, and he got caught doing it.
Three-quarter time at Newcastle, and the Brisbane Bullets scored 36 points in term number three. After leading by just three at halftime, they now have a 19-point buffer at the last break. Brisbane 79, Newcastle 60. What a block. Tony Ronaldson swats the ball away from Matt Nilsson, and here comes Sam Mackinnon. 80 seconds left on the game clock. From close range, Wheeler makes two. He draws a foul on Kelsey Weems, and we'll get a chance at a three-point play.
And that's what happens when you make good, strong moves to the basket. Sam Mackinnon was just exploring off the dribble, brought two defenders, and kicked it to the wide-open Brett Wheeler, who had a much smaller Kelsey Weems on the rotate and drop.
So after tying the ball game away 30 seconds earlier, the Kings now find themselves 5 points in arrears again. Here's Shane Hill against Mackinnon to the baseline. Another quick whistle provided by Alan Godden on this occasion. Mackinnon picks up his second personal. And Shane Hill goes to the stripe.
Wow, that was really, really a tight call.
If anybody pushed off, it was Shane Heal as he was trying to get a little room for the step back.
Fans will see some poetic justice in that. Shane Heal makes one. One of four from the stripe, very uncharacteristic for Shane Heal, who is in the top 10 in the league in that category, or should I say was, because he's just dropped out, one suspects. Final 60 seconds of the first half, Drimmick couldn't get it away. Brett Wheeler came back up with it. Now Kelly, Ronaldson looking inside, but Mackinnon gets it before Frank Drimmick. Turn away and jump shot from Frank Drimmick. He is now into double figures as well, as the Magic lead it by six. Shane Heal against Mackinnon. Again, contact, this time no whistle. The hammer pulls away and drops three more. Well, that eases the situation for Sydney.
2-point basket to Shane Heal.
It's been called a two. Heal now up to 8 points in the game. 8 points in the game. Kings trail by four as the Magic milk the clock for the last shot of the first half. One stage in the first term, the Kings led by seven. Magic have led by double figures here in term number two. Now have 9.5 seconds left and 5 seconds on the shot clock to get one away here. This is Drimmick against Shane Heal. Short with the shot, it's loose. He's going to get it back on the buzzer. He fires for three, couldn't get it to go. Mike Kelly will get one last chance. He too comes up empty for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. But as we head to the halftime break, it is the home team in front by four. The Southeast Melbourne Magic 57, Sydney 53, here on Fox. To Melbourne Park, halftime here, and the Southeast Melbourne Magic have a 4 point break, 57-53. Of course, they are playing without their point guard and top scorer Clint McDaniel, who will be out for some 6 or 7 weeks with a groin strain. Billy McCaffrey, who played here with the Magic a couple of years ago, will return hopefully for their match against Illawarra on Wednesday. And speaking of point guards, well, arguably the best we've seen in this country in the 1990s is Ricky Grace of the Perth Wildcats. He has maintained a high level of competition while winning championships with Perth. Let's delve into the history books and get a look at Ricky Grace.
Big start for Traher and the Wildcats.
Reddy's lost the handle under good pressure from Grace. Traher, the no-look pass back to the maestro, and he comes up with two more.
First of all, Rick, congratulations for being nominated to the NBL 20th anniversary team. It must be quite an honor.
Yeah, it is. It's definitely an honor to be, as you say, nominated, and such a great group of guys, too. And, to be considered in the top 50 is definitely a great honor.
When did you start to think that this was going to be your home and your career here in Australia?
Well, I definitely came to Australia, as most imports do, thinking that I'll give it 1 or 2 years, paid holiday, and hopefully improve my game and go to the NBA. But I think, especially coming here in Perth, the people here are so nice. It's such a professional organization. I could see where I could possibly make a career out of this. And I think after about that second championship, I think this club started to understand me a bit more and accept me. And I started to understand what the club expected. And, we've made a happy combination.
And the Wildcats go chasing it, as do the Suns. Grace comes up with it, though.
Nice play from the Wildcats.
I know you're an Australian citizen. Has that helped you settle in and kind of has it made it easier to play basketball?
Well, I think becoming an Australian citizen didn't have really anything to do with basketball. It just was my statement to, I guess, this country and to the people of Perth that, you know, I have made this my home. And, you know, I was hoping to play and represent Australia, but that didn't work out. But by me becoming a citizen wasn't really a basketball decision. It was more of my commitment to Australia.
Do you ever wonder what it would be like if you were thrown in this situation where you didn't have a whole lot of talent around you?
Yeah, I sometimes wonder, you know, what it would be like to be able to show all of my skills, you know, but I feel that if I show 70% of my skills and the team is playing at 95% is better than me showing 95% of my skills and the team playing at 70%. So, you know, I've just always tried to, I guess, pick and choose when to show my talents, whereas a lot of imports, I think, you know, are probably more aggressive in showing their talents. And this club doesn't really want that from their imports. I think they want to promote the Australian side of things a bit more than I think the American import side of things. And I'm happy with that.
Grace makes them both.
One of the things that a lot of people say is that you're an underrated player. Do you think so, and does it bother you?
In some cases, I think I'm underrated. There are certainly aspects of my game that I feel underrated, and that's only because I haven't shown them as much as a lot of imports. But I've been, you know, blessed to have a lot of talent around me. I don't really have to show those skills, but. You know, this club definitely knows the value that I am to this team, and you know, that's just something that I feel is unselfish, and I think you have to be unselfish to actually win championships, and that's the only reason I basically play.
What do you think it would have been that has gotten you chosen for the 20th anniversary team?
Well, you know, there are a lot of great guards that have come out here, such as yourself, you know, the Ruckers, the McDonald's, and there are a lot of great Australian guards, Phil Smythe, Andrew Gaze, and all those guys. And, you know, if I'm fortunate enough to be chosen, I just think it would be the unselfishness that I've given to this organization in order to, I think, for this club, this team to win championships, and that's the only reason I play is for championships. It's a great honor just to be nominated in the 50, and if I'm in the final 10, I would be, you know, I guess the Aussie term is stoked, you know. But you know, there are a lot of great players that missed out. You know, I was just talking to Mike Ellis, who captained our team for 10 great years, and won two championships, and played a lot of, represented Australia, who didn't even make the team. So I'm blessed and fortunate just to be nominated in this 20th anniversary season for the top 50 players.
Ricky Grace having another stellar year with the Perth Wildcats, who are one of only three teams in the league at the moment to be above 500, and they are looking good for the playoffs. Tonight they are entertaining the Melbourne Tigers, and we shall update scores for you as they become available. But certainly Fox Sports cameras will be in Perth, an upcoming match for them against the Adelaide 36ers. Trust you can join us for that, because generally the Wildcats against Adelaide is a very, very entertaining affair. Saturday, May 16th, you get to watch Ricky Grace in action. At the moment, he is the second best three-point shooter in the league and top six in assists as well. So while Ricky Grace is having a good year, the Magic are having a great first half here. They lead it 57-53. More from Melbourne Park right after this.
On your mark, ready, set, let's go. Dance for pro, I know you know. I go psycho when my new joint hit. Just can't sit, gotta get jiggy with it. That's it, now honey, come ride.
KNY, all up in my eyes. You got a Prada bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friend, let's spin. Everybody looking at me, glancing at the kid, wishing they was dancing a jig here with this handsome kid. Sick a cigar right from Cuba Cuba. I just bite it, it's for the look. I don't light it. Fill me on the hand, stay roll play. Give it up, Jiggy, make it feel like foreplay. Yo, my cardio is infinite. Ha ha, Big Willie style's all in it. Getting jiggy with it.
And welcome back to Melbourne Park. And you can see one of the heavy hitters at the NBL office, Bill Palmer, getting in the spirit of things. He was, of course, with the Southeast. Well, actually, he was just the East Side Spectres back then. He was sporting a beard and a lot more hair back then. But he is showing good spirit and getting into the retro theme of the celebration year of 20 years here in the NBL. Great to see him do that. Let's check out the stats after one half place. Southeast Melbourne Magic on top. Really, no surprises there, 57-53. But the surprise is that they're doing it, shooting 37% from the field, 21-56, while the Sydney Kings are 19-38. And that's a lot of shots to be given up in trailing and giving them that many rebounds, offensive rebounds, the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Free throw shooting, the Sydney Kings 12 of 18, starting to pick up at 66%. The Magic 12 of 15. 3-point shooting, the Magic only 3 of 14 at 21%. The Sydney Kings have only launched off 5, and that's because the Southeast Melbourne Magic are not giving them the 3-point shot. The Magic only 2 turnovers, 12 to 7 on the assist, and 29 to 24 on the rebounds. Top scorers after one half of play, Frank Drimmick with 11, and boy, hasn't he played well in recent weeks. Brett Wheeler and Sam Mackinnon also are top scoring with them at 11. Tony Ronaldson with 8, Mike Kelly has 6, doing a great defensive job, and Jason Smith with 6 as well. For the Sydney Kings, Kelsey Weems has 14 to lead the way for the Kings. Bruce Bolden with 13, Shane Heal, they have been wearing him like a cheap suit with 8. Maddie Nielsen with 7, and Aaron Trahair 5, and Evers Burns has 4 points and a few fouls to go with that.
Well, the Southeast Melbourne Magic have produced plenty of talent, and Chris Anstey is certainly proving their system quite good at the moment. Having a chat there with 3 gentlemen, and I'm sure someone above that poster. He attracts a lot of attention now with the Dallas Mavericks, Chris Anstey, and we were looking at his numbers earlier this year. Finished his season playing 41 of Dallas's 82 games, averaged 6 points and 4 rebounds, which is a pretty good return. Had a career-high 26 points and 8 rebounds against Boston. Had 19 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists in a match against the Phoenix Suns, and a career-high 12 rebounds against the Miami Heat after making his debut against the Portland Trailblazers back on the 8th of November. Good to see Chris Anstey back to lift some of the flagging spirits of the Magic, because they do have injury problems. And one man who was going to be out for a week or two and hasn't played for 7 games is their veteran Andrew Parkinson, who's joined me here. Andrew, to update your injury problem with your back.
Well, I've missed 7 games, and Monday morning I'm having an epidural, which is they give to women giving birth to aid them. But for me, it's going to help my sciatic nerve, and hopefully I'll be back on court in a couple of weeks.
Well, let's hope you are. At the moment, though, the Magic are traveling pretty well. And Brett Wheeler did well to keep that alive. They start the second half in front by 4. Mackinnon looking to extend it short on the iron. Burns had it, then lost it. Kelly with the scraps. And Mike Kelly comes up with a second effort to extend the lead out to 6. Heal down low, Burns against Ronaldson. Double team by Mackinnon coming in. Traveling violation against Evers Burns. And Parky, I might ask you, are you a little surprised that Kings haven't tried to take it at the Magic so far, given the fact you're playing obviously with 8 players, but Ben Knight and John Dorgie sparingly? You don't have a lot of depth there.
Yeah, we must remember the Kings had a tough game last night against the Giants in Sydney, so they've travelled down today on the plane. So I guess they do have a bit more depth than us as it goes with bodies, but you know, we're a pretty well-conditioned team, and you know, we've taken at them at the post a lot.
This is Kelsey Weems, who has been important in the match. 14 points, he leads the game. confronted by Mike Kelly. Goes to McGregor, who has Ronaldson to contend with. Shane, who was left wide open. Couldn't make it go, however. And Frank Drimmick came up with the rebound ahead of Matty Nilsson. Brings the ball forward, trying to get past Nilsson, who's forced him into error. And will the Kings come up with it? No, Mackinnon retrieves it to Drimmick. And he shows some patience there not to let the early shot away.
Yeah, that was one of the things Brian Gorgian spoke about at halftime, was quick shooting the ball, and the Kings got a lot of good opportunities off some quick shots.
Ronaldson pulls the trigger. Higher percentage shot, and it falls for the Bear. Now into double figures. He has 10 points. And the lead is out to 8 after some 2 minutes of term number 3. Weems crashes to the floor. Some confusion about possession here. Yeah, he's slow in getting back to his feet.
He's got him up. I've talked to both of you. I don't know. I'm not watching.
Referees are going to jump it, it would appear. Let's have a look at it in replay. Weems bouncing the ball off his foot, apparently. Mike Kelly believing that it was a magic ball. But Nilsson and Mackinnon are going to try and decide it anyway.
Hold it up again. Throw it up. Through the ball over. Through the ball to the left.
Scott Cogley doing the honours, if Matt Nilsson and Sam Mackinnon will let him. A little bit of pride on the line here to see who's going to get the tip. It comes to Weems. Nilsson did well there against the athletic Mackinnon. Now McGregor working against Wheeler. Weems fires. This is for three. Hard on the iron. And Mackinnon comes up with it. Ronaldson hands off to Mike Kelly as the Magic come quickly up the floor. Now they're going to set it up. Ronaldson down to the baseline. They've left him all alone. Too easy. Tony Ronaldson gets to the hole. He now has 12 to lead the Magic.
We've got the ball handlers out there, but normally Tony doesn't take up those duties. But as he showed there, he can definitely handle the ball.
6 unanswered points to start term number 3 for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Has them in front by 10. Here comes Frank Drimmick, arguably the most versatile player in the National Basketball League. One match earlier this year, given the Magic's injury woes, he played all 5 positions. And Tony Ronaldson has looked impressive in this match. He connects from downtown. The lead is out to 13, biggest in the match so far.
Yeah, we like to call Frank Drimmick the package. That's what he's known as, because he does play just about every position on the floor. He is the total package. And he had a good game last week on the Foxtel game on the Friday, which 31 points against Newcastle.
8 of 11 from downtown. He was threatening to push past two of the record books. We were hoping that he was going to miss a couple.
Yes, well, you actually mentioned it on the commentary, and I was sitting at home panicking myself. So I think definitely, though, with Frank's career, he'll probably end up having all 10 of those three-point records in there, along with a lot of other records.
Tell us about the Magic, how they are able to maintain such an efficient record despite these injury problems. I think I'm right in saying that no other team could have sustained the injuries that you have and kept on winning. You lose your point guard and top scorer, Clint McDaniel. You come out on Wednesday night and beat Canberra. And not a lot of other teams in the league that could do without their point guard, top scorer. John George has been out for some time. You're out at the moment and still be successful. How do you manage to do that?
Yeah, well, the Magic have been known for their depth. And I think what you've got to realise is that Jason Smith and Frank Drimmick are both coming off the bench for the Magic, and they're performing extremely well, and they're just about ready to bust out. And I think Frank's been starting. He replaced Sam when he went away for his tryout with the NBA, and he's also starting now that Clint's out. So Frank's getting a lot more opportunity, and Jason. But yeah, I think the day-to-day work that the Magic do, to answer your question, is the thing that keeps the team well conditioned as well as mentally fresh.
It's Tony Ronaldson banging in 3 more. The Bear is averaging 16 points per game so far in season 1998. 32% from beyond the arc, 29 of 90. Now Bronson's on the floor. Burns got rid of him. Now he has to play with his back to him. Wheeler read that pretty well and has won possession for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. The Kings turn the ball over for the 11th time as Drimmick hands off to his partner in crime. And upstairs, Sam Mackinnon throws one down. He now has 13 points in the match. And this is getting away from the Kings. They have not scored here in term number three. And we've played 3.5 minutes. The Southeast Melbourne Magic have added 11 to lead it by 15. Wings. Now Nilsson. A lot of standing around here for the Sydney Kings. Bolden inside. Bad pass for Nilsson. Now McKinnon's got it and they're off and running again. Takes Shane Hill on with a height advantage. Couldn't make it tumble, however. And now Weems will come forward as the Kings go 3-on-2. Firing Shane Hill. They need this, and he breaks the drought after 4 minutes of turn number three. Shane Hill finds the target for the Kings.
That's where the Sydney Kings are dangerous. Shane Hill on transition. He's playing the two spot now that Kelsey Weems is at the one. And when the Magic quick shoot the ball, the Sydney Kings end up in transition, and that's what they can do.
Alan Godden has now called a foul on Shane Hill when it appeared that the Magic had turned the ball over. Hill has his second personal foul. Doesn't like the call. Mike Kelly will restart play. Catch and shoot Tony Ronaldson. Couldn't get it to fit. Hill came up with the rebound. His second in the match is Weems. Spins around Mike Kelly. Fires hard on the iron. Kept alive by Bruce Bolden. Shane Hill goes to work down to the baseline. No room for the shot. Guarded by Ronaldson for the moment. Two starters on the Australian Olympic team. Hill determined to find a way past. It spills to Burns. Now Weems firing from the top of the key and it tumbles. User-friendly roll for Kelsey Weems. He is now up to 17 points and leads the game.
He's not allowed to get a roll like that in a court. I think it's the first time he's played here. Well, definitely against us, so... He shouldn't get that.
Drimmick fires, pushed off balance by the D. Couldn't make it fit. And the Magic are going to come up with possession as it spills out of court. Scott Cogley makes the call. 9-point break to the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Kings have scored the last 6 points and need another stop here as we count down the last 7 minutes of term number three. Wheeler up there at the offensive end. Couldn't reel it in. Not very often, Parkey, that we see a team with more offensive rebounds than defensive rebounds, but that's what the Magic have done here. 18 offensive, 15 defensive.
Yeah, that definitely kept us in the game at halftime, and something the coach mentioned at halftime. I think we had 18 at halftime, and the Kings only had probably less than half than that. Just one shot there by Weems. The Magic... got to try and give the Kings one shot at the hoop and then get it back for themselves.
Drimmick wide open and he drains it. Frank Drimmick now up to 14 points, 2 of 5 from beyond the perimeter. He also has 6 rebounds. Lead back to an even dozen. Oh, excellent pass from Kelsey Weems. He spots Bolden open. And easy work for Big Bruce, who now has 15 points. Only Weems with 17 has more for the Sydney Kings. It's a 10-point break, 6 minutes and 6 seconds out from three-quarter time. And I know it's very frustrating, Parky, for players to sit on the bench and not be able to play with injury, but I guess if you're going to miss games, you'd prefer to be missing games when these players have to wear those shortened shorts.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's a few guys out there, particularly the big guys. I think Evers Burns and Tony Ronaldson didn't look the greatest in those shorts, but I think a few of the Sydney Kings fellas have swapped at halftime. I think they should lose a few points for that if they've got a different uniform. Isn't that the case? It used to be the case in juniors.
It was, and certainly Simon Dwight last night on Fox Sports, his short shorts lasted until the first time out, and then he changed his shorts over, so not a favourite with everyone, but great to see the fans getting involved here. And Parky, an opportunity for us to thank you for your contribution. Nice to have a chat with you, and we look forward to seeing you back in the longer shorts before the finals come around.
Thanks a lot, John, it's great to be here.
Andrew Parkinson, injured star from the Southeast Melbourne Magic, joining us here on Fox. Steve Carfino will resume his position, and there is the three-point bomb from Kelsey Weems. And then Frank Drimmick with the answer at the other end. What a year Frank Drimmick is having. 14 points, 6 rebounds for Drimmick. And that is right on his season average. He is also sixth in the league at 44% from three-point territory. Back underway here, less than 6 minutes away from the final break. Ronaldson steps inside Shane Hill. Wheeler's the open man, and he puts a lid on two.
From that timeout, Brian Gorton was furious at Brett Wheeler when Bruce Bolden was able to get that wide open layup. That's about the first easy shot the Kings have gotten all night.
Kings being harassed by Frank Drimmick. Penetrating. Now Matty Nielsen firing from the baseline. Two pieces of the iron. Weems has got it back. He forces the shot and it tumbles. Well, the Kings struggling at the moment, but Kelsey Weems is showing his class. 19 points. He leads the game. Kings just having a few problems stopping the Magic in offense. This is Kelly, quick hands, Ronaldson firing over Bolden. Three more for the Bears. 4 of 9 from downtown, 18 points. He leads the Magic.
The Magic just go that extra pass so well. And that time Tony Ronaldson nails it on the finish.
Nielsen with the open jumper. Couldn't get it to fit. Mackinnon comes up with the rebound. That's his 10th to go with 13 points and 5 assists. Drimmick wants a foul. And Eddie Crouch has provided a whistle. Drimmick will be going to the stripe where he is a perfect 2 of 2 in this match.
Hands on the elbow. We got three.
Three shots.
Second foul on Kelsey
right
Weems.
There, yes.
Jason Smith checks into the game for the Magic.
He's right there.
And Kelsey asking Eddie Crouch if he saw him actually hit the elbow, and that is a really tough play to see. But you really have to watch for it as a referee because it throws your shot off so bad when a guy flicks your elbow at the point of release.
Drimmick just misses with the third attempt, but the lead is back to 15 in favor of the Southeast Melbourne Magic. 4.5 minutes away from three-quarter time. Hill couldn't get that to fit. He was 2 of 12 when this venue earlier in the season. Finished with 15 points in this match. He is 2 of 4 from three-point territory. Both teams are struggling from that area. Mackinnon, look out! Well, if they leave Sam Mackinnon in that much space, it's highly unlikely that he's not going to ram the ball straight down the throat of the Sydney Kings. And now the lead has exploded out to 17 and looks like being extended as Smith is fouled from behind by Scotty McGregor. Just feeling his shoulder there for the moment as well. And an intentional foul is called on Scott McGregor. I don't know whether I agree with that, Steve.
How is that no play for the ball? He was like 2 inches from the ball. I don't understand this rule at all, and I hope Gary Fox rings me on this one, because how is that?
Slapped him on the arm.
Slapped him on the arm. It was like
nothing else.
Probably the hand. And then last night, watching that game, and one of the Tigers puts a bear hug on the Canberra Cannons, and that's not an intentional foul. I just want to know the ruling on it, because that is not even being close to being called consistently. Yeah, so that's got to be a problem.
Well, I'm sure Gary Fox will have discussions during the week about that. I agree, Steve. The lead is out to 19 at the moment. Is this getting away from the Kings? Well, they were 21 down at one stage last evening against North Melbourne and came home to win it. Ronaldson did well there to retrieve his earlier mistake. And the Magic have turned the ball over only 3 times in the match, compared with 14 from Sydney. Mackinnon fires for three. Two pieces of the iron. Smith keeps it alive. He goes back to the well. And this time he draws a foul on Matty Nielsen.
Well, watch the replay. Jason Smith knows he's going to just step in there for a... And if there's an intentional foul called, why not that one? But because it wasn't wide open, and because it wasn't, you didn't have time to think about it, he goes, and it definitely didn't want him to get the ball up and didn't make a play for the ball.
It did look a little more like an intentional foul than the one called on Scotty McGregor. 3.5 minutes left here. And I guess some poetic justice there as Jason Smith misses with both. So we have a 19-point break in favour of the Magic. The pass from Burns was wayward. Bruce Bolden couldn't reel it in. They turn the ball over for the 15th time. 19 offensive rebounds to 9 in favour of the Magic. That is a startling statistic. Here's Ronaldson, close to the defender. He now has 20. First player to reach that area in the game, and the lead is out to 21. Kings have been restricted to just 10 points here in term number 3. And Shane Hill has lost the handle working against Jason Smith. And has won possession for the Kings.
Good hustle by Jason Smith. The Magic just cranking it up on the very frustrated Sydney Kings, making everything they do extremely difficult. And Jason Smith getting after the ball on that loose ball.
27 points to 10 here in term number 3. The Magic have scored the last 11, and the Kings need a break. Weems draws a foul on Mike Kelly. That will be his fourth personal. Did jar his hand. It's the left hand, I believe. He looks in a little bit of trouble.
Man, he hit it pretty hard. That was hurt. This game is being played very physical. These guys getting their money's worth on the foul. What gets me is on those intentional calls, where do they come from? They just come out of nowhere. I mean, they've been fouling each other like crazy all night, and then one of those is an intentional call.
Did I hear you saying to Mal Cooper last night that you don't criticize referees?
Yeah. The funny thing was, I was just joking, and I said that you did, and he had to go at you.
He doesn't know how painful it is sitting on the fence sometimes.
Well, I think the referees do a good job, but there are just some things that I just think need to be clarified. And that's one of them is that you're under the basket, can't get a charge call. That's one of them. And that continuation's another one. And that intentional foul call, that's the worst.
Here's Mike Kelly. They've lost the ball, the Magic, and that's unusual in this match. Hill comes up with it. Weems has the hot hand at the moment. Penetrating. Outside is Aaron Traher, who has seen limited minutes in this match. He tries to force a shot and comes up empty, and now a foul will be called on the Southeast Melbourne Magic. No, in fact, it's going to be on Bruce Bolden, who now has his third personal foul. Kings in the bonus situation, so the Magic are going to the strike. Here it is in replay. Bolden just muscling Tony Rollinson out of the equation.
Simmer it down up there, up and down the floor, you two. Simmer it down.
That's Eddie Crouch talking with Ronaldson and Evers Burns.
I was talking to both of you.
Well, usually when a game is being played at this intensity and how physical this game has been, it'll usually go in the favor of the Southeast Melbourne Magic. And that's been the case tonight. Brad Rosen checks in for the Sydney Kings, and usually that means a tempo change or some kind of a change.
Took over 2 minutes left here in term number 3. Burns from the baseline, he nails it. Only 6 points in the match for Evers Burns. He had 31 in their victory last night over North Melbourne. So as we saw Robert Rose go from 5 to 35, we've seen Evers Burns go from 31 to 6, although we still have a quarter and a bit remaining. And Tony Ronaldson ices 3 more. 25 points, a game high. 5 of 10 from beyond the perimeter for Tony Ronaldson.
25 points for Tony Ronaldson.
Burns in traffic against Ronaldson. Claims 2 more. The Kings can't afford to keep trading baskets with the Magic because they trail at the moment by some 21 points. Now we're going to have a foul call by Eddie Crouch. And it's going to be on Evers Burns.
We've got two.
That will be his fourth personal.
two.
We hear Eddie talking.
You can't do it. You can't go up and bang a guy. Well, that's why I talked to both of you.
That was Burns saying that he's been banging me all the way down the court, but Eddie has been talking to those guys, and if you're going to bang, don't do it right in front of the official.
Particularly after he has just warned you. Here's Brad Rosen, been injected into the game. I'm surprised Stephen Whitehead hasn't seen a little more court time, considering his heroics to win the match last night for the Sydney Kings with 15 points in the final term. That's a tough shot from Matt Nilsson, but he makes it fit. Now Alan Godden comes into the equation, and another foul has been called on Evers Burns. That is his fifth personal, and Burns is going to have to sit down.
We couldn't see it really, but Evers Burns has lost in this battle of, what do you want to call it, physical play, wits, whatever, but he needs to be in the game. He needs to play more minutes for the Sydney Kings. He's a force for them in the middle every time down in the last couple of possessions for the Sydney Kings. They've gone to him and he scored quite easily. But you need to be on the court to make those plays.
So a 23-point ball game in favor of the Magic. They have stomped all over the Sydney Kings here in turn number three, And finally the Kings are going to get a call. Shane Hill will present himself on the foul line.
Now Gorgon and Shane Hill having a few words. But this game is really something else. And of course, I'm not promoting it, but boy, these referees have done I think they've done a great job at just preventing a fight. It's been that physical.
Two shots. Tell him. You're right with three. Yeah. He's certain with three. Hold it. What he's got. Go out and even close. That's a foot inside the line. The foot inside the line.
Brian Gorchi and Dane Baresk in the background. The difference was 1 point. His team's in front by 20. As we saw in Newcastle. He wants everything that his team deserves. They were adamant that Shane Hill was inside the stripe. Here's Smith. He gets monstered by Bruce Bolden. There's value for your foul. And that will be the fourth personal on Bruce Bolden. Smith will go back to the stripe.
Let's go. Two. Did you hit him?
As you can see, Burns has to sit down because of five fouls. Bolden joins Nilsson in the red zone as well. Kelly has four. Trimick, Smith and Mackinnon with three apiece. Kings have 22 fouls, which is one above their season average. The Magic have 15. Their season average is 22. Brad Rosen pushing the tempo to Hill. Inside Mackinnon, confronted by Ronaldson. Couldn't get the shot to tumble, and Trimick came up with the rebound. Kings down by 22, 30 seconds away from three-quarter time. Shot clock some 7 seconds inside the game clock that you see bottom right of your screen. Mackinnon patient, being guarded by Traher in a mismatch in terms of athleticism. Shot clock now down to seven. The man is Smith in the corner, firing for three. He extends the Southeast Melbourne Magic's lead. It's now out to 25. Hill, the length of the court. Now he's had to cough it up. Ben Knight won't have time for the shot. And they don't need it at the moment, though, because the Southeast Melbourne Magic have turned this game around in turn number three. They led by only four at halftime. At the final break, they lead by 25. The Magic, 98, lead Sydney 73 here on Fox.
Well, Jason Smith's the best three-point shooter in the land, and Sam Mackinnon's out there on a 1-4 flat. The Sydney Kings lead the best shooter in the league from outside the arc, wide open for a wide open look. The Magic take about 500 shots in their individuals every day. He's not going to miss that shot. And it just seems as if when you play against a good team, they just really make your flaws quite evident. This has got to be the longest train of afros I've ever seen. That is incredible. And it's not just the young kids or the fanatics. Man, it's got parents with afros and long hair and beads. They're all getting into it with their kids. It's been a great night out for the family. As you kind of look at the range of ages with the people participating in this retro night. Job well done to the organization here at the Southeast Melbourne Magic. There's some bad throws.
Steve, this certainly has captured the imagination of the basketball public. Retro week all around Australia. Everyone been getting in the spirit. Dear, oh dear. One of the former members of ABBA has made her way down to the floor. That's going to be hard to beat, surely.
And the winner is Royster Sims.
That punk of a man in that striped captain.
We've got a man in a striped captain. Let's give our competitors a round of applause as they leave the court right now.
That's pretty good.
Leave the court right now.
That's it. I say that's pretty
bad. Of course,
bad.
Our overall winner is
Look at that outfit. He actually had that in his possession. Went into his closet. What am I going to wear to retro night? It wasn't even in the back of the closet, probably.
Well, the Southeast Melbourne Magic absolutely annihilated Sydney, 41-20 in term number three. Tony Ronaldson had more. He had 21 points alone. The Kings could manage 20 only as a team. Ronaldson now with 29 points leads the match. Weems has 20 for Sydney. Would you believe 41 points in a quarter is not even good enough to get the Magic into their top 10 of all time? 48 is their record against Hobart in 1990. Twice had 44 against the Gold Coast in 1995. 21 points in a quarter for Tony Ronaldson is a pretty impressive display.
It'll be interesting to see if this game continues to be as physical as it is. I hope not. They really need to just calm down and finish out the rest of this game. Not give up or anything, but I just think these fouls are very hard, every one of them.
Drimmick working against Shane Hill. Down to the baseline. No room for the shot. Mackinnon didn't have a lot of room either, but somehow he finds the target. 17 points, 10 rebounds, 7 assists. Now for Sam Mackinnon. 100 points already for the Magic. That is their season average. Shane Hill draws a foul, working hard to the hoop. He is fired up.
And watch Ben Knight come over from the help side. And he's put on some K's since he's joined the Magic camp. Ben Knight is Sam Mackinnon. Actually, did he get the foul, Sam Mackinnon? As I thought Ben Knight did as he came for the help. But he didn't budge. Shane Hill had a full head of steam turning the corner. And he went up there and contested that shot, made Shane earn it from the line.
Those 21 points for Tony Ronaldson will put him eighth overall in a 20-year history of the NBL. His points scored in the third quarter. Boy, has he had a hot hand. Inside the pass intended for Ben Knight, spills out of court. He did it unobtrusively as well. Mind you, when your team scores 41, it's hard to keep track of who's scoring the points. Here's Trahair. Excellent looking shot. Painted it by Leonard Copeland. Trahair has his own version, but the Kings still trail by 23. Drimmick goes to Ronaldson from three-point territory. He's missed. Just something of a surprise. Now Shane Hill has Traher ahead of him and Bruce Bolden. He works down to the baseline. Nilsson is the trailer. The pass was intended for Bruce Bolden, I assume, because it was going straight to Sam Mackinnon. His no-look pass. He's got it back and he stuffed it in the hole. It bounced off Matty Nilsson. Mackinnon scooped it up, elevated upstairs. Get another look at this.
It just bounces right back to him. He got a break. It's one thing to be lucky and pick up the ball. Another thing to be able to be lucky, pick it up and finish like that. That's nasty.
Ginnon now into the 20s as well. He needs three more assists for a triple-double. This is Weems. His team struggling. He works into the paint, and a classy move again from Kelsey Weems.
And that was a very good defender. He just shook out of his boots right there. Jason Smith on just a ridiculous crossover to get to the hole.
Ben Knight, formerly on Sydney's roster, working against Nilsson, got him in the air. Excellent move from Ben Knight. His first points in the match, and now all eight players for the Southeast Melbourne Magic are on the score sheet, including five in double figures, and Mike Kelly with eight. Smith stripped the ball away from Bolden. He'll be too athletic for Shane Hill, one presumes. And he invents a shot. It was a hook running to the baseline off balance, I believe. He now has 15 points. And the Southeast Melbourne Magic are putting on a show.
No one, Jay. Hey! Watch it!
The Kings have been on the end of some thumpings this year. And the three counts for Aaron Traher.
Well, that's why you have to run at him very hard. The Magic been doing that all night to the Sydney Kings three-point shooters. They have to go way downtown like that to get one off.
Drimmick firing. He too connects from downtown. Three of six for Frank Drimmick. 19 points in the game. Kings lost to Brisbane by 30. They lost to the Melbourne Tigers by 29. Shane Hill helps them out with three more. They lost to the Magic earlier this year by 27. Newcastle had their number by 26. Adelaide beat them by 19. They're down by 25 at the moment. Incidentally, the Kings' biggest winning margin for the year is 27 against Canberra. Back in January, opening round. Here's Ronaldson muscling his way to the hoop. Two more, back to the stripe. Tony Ronaldson is having his best game of the year so far.
And this is just brute strength from the lower body. Tony Ronaldson keeps his balance after the contact is made. Puts up a nice soft shot, didn't even have to use the glass. That was very impressive.
Ronaldson has played over 250 NBL games, his career high is 35. He has 32 in this match as Weems fires. It's off the mark. Can Nilsson keep it alive? Well, he did, but had a foot on the line. In fact, 34 is Tony Ronaldson's career high to match his singlet number. The one suspects, with more than 7.5 minutes remaining, that may go by the wayside. Normally it's Frank Drimmick who's setting career highs on Fox. Tony Ronaldson wants a piece of the action as well. Here he is against Burns, trying to draw another foul on Burns. He's playing with five, as is Bruce Bolden. And here he comes, steaming up the floor. Shane Hill lost the handle. Weems is wide open, and he makes them pay. 4 of 10 from downtown. Kelsey Weems now with 25 points in the match. 4 assists, 4 rebounds, couple of steals. He has been a lone hand somewhat for the Sydney Kings against the Magic.
Stand up, cut it out, you two!
Still more body work off the ball as Jason Smith fires. He now is getting in on the act as well. Weems comes forward. Smith up to 18, Weems up to 27.
And Weems goes across the Magic bench. And guess who had a few words to say to him down there? Oh, Clint McDaniel. He's not even, they have a uniform on. Got something to say.
Inside Traher goes to Burns, confronted by Dorge and Jason Smith coming in late. Burns will go back to the charity stripe. Foul is going to be called on John George. That is his first personal. Ronaldson sits down with 32 points. 5 of 11 from the car park, 7 of 7 from the charity stripe. That has been the story of the night for the Sydney Kings. 18 of 27 from the stripe at 66%. Burns makes the second. Magic by 25, 6.5 minutes remaining. Drimmick will do the ball carrying duties for the Southeast Melbourne Magic. Still no sign of Stephen Whitehead. May have been looking forward to a little bit more court time after coming up with 21 points, a season high last night. But not so, as Drimmick misses from close range. Rosen, too quick for Kelly. Outside, the three-point specialist, Aaron Trahair, gets it. He misses. It's out of court. The Magic will come up with possession. Magic have turned the ball over only 5 times, Steve. That's a tremendous game from them. 19 offensive rebounds to 9. They really have put on a good show here with 8 players. And they include the rookie Ben Knight and John George on the road from injury.
And considering how physical this game has been played, those 5 turnovers are really amazing then.
Well, we mentioned at the top of the program that the Magic have shown themselves to be the team to beat this year, right from day one. We're getting more evidence of it here, Steve.
Well, Newcastle, they just pounded the Falcons, and then here they've virtually been having to play with 7 players because John George hasn't had a whole lot of minutes.
Hill has support, doesn't need it. Goes to the hoop, banks 2 off the glass. He is now up to 21 points. George inside, baby hook shot, wooden tumble. Shane Hill comes up with it after Matty Nilsson hit it in his direction. Now Rosen pulling up for the jumper. High off the glass, user-friendly roll for Brad Rosen. Billy Tomlinson hasn't got much to smile about, however. Scotty McGregor sitting on the bench with just 2 points. Hasn't seen a lot of court time, but has taken only 1 shot in the match. Whitehead has only taken one shot in the match as well and hasn't scored after having 21 last night. Burns had 31 last night, has 9 at the moment. But Kelsey Weems, who was restricted to 15 against North Melbourne last night, has 27, and only Ronaldson with 32 has more in the match.
Well, the Magic have only shot at a 45% clip to the Sydney Kings 52, but the Magic have taken 88 shots to the Kings 65.
Here's Drimmick penetrating, firing over the outstretched arm of Aaron Trahair. Nilsson had it, has his problems, however. Did that well under pressure. Hands off to Brad Rosen. Quickly up the floor, Brad Williams is checked into the game. Now Burns, awkward-looking shot, couldn't get it to fall, and George comes up with the rebound. Alley-oop play to Jason Smith from three-quarter court from Mike Kelly. They're going to get the 2 anyway. They are starting to add insult to injury here. Southeast Melbourne Magic get it out to a 23-point buffer. 4:20 left here from Melbourne Park. This is Williams, has the shot blocked by Jason Smith, and now Kelly is with it. Drimmick was the intended recipient, but Trahair read it well from close range. He misses. Rosen coughs it up as well. But Mike Kelly had a hand on the ball and a foot on the line. He bails the Sydney Kings out. They maintain possession as Burns goes to the bench, replaced by Scotty McGregor.
That's such a good defensive play by Mike Kelly. That's an easy layup for Aaron Trahair. But he had to make up for that bad pass.
Trahair fires for 3 and hits the target. Trahair now has 13 points in the match, 3 of 4 from beyond the perimeter. Magic have 5 players in double figures, all above 15. It's been a great spread from them. This man is one of them. As Mackinnon goes to the hoop without success, Wheeler's got the offensive rebound and the putback. He now has 17 points. 7 of 10 from the field, 11 rebounds as well. And the Kings have coughed the ball up again. Well, there hasn't been a lot to enthuse about from the Sydney Kings' point of view tonight. Magic's 132 against Newcastle, the highest for two seasons, as Kelly now into double figures, the sixth player to do so. And the assist from Mackinnon gives him a triple-double. 20 points, 10 rebounds, 10 assists. A slamming Sam, still with 3 minutes to play. McGregor couldn't get that to fit. It spills to Drimmick. Pass McGregor and Trehair in one stride. The alley-oop play for Mackinnon was prevented by the rim. The rim doing what the Sydney Kings D has been unable to do, and that stopped the South East Melbourne Magic. Crazy couldn't get it to go. The rebound to John Dorge. The Kings aren't playing too much D at the moment. Travelling violation is called on Sam Mackinnon. His first turnover in the match.
And the Sydney Kings read that alley-oop play, but still the athleticism of Sam Mackinnon was up there to dunk it anyway. For the rim. Balls, balls are numbers 3-0, he had to reach down to get that. He's way above the rim. Rosen. Trehair to McGregor.
Scotty McGregor finds the target from outside. Quarter time in Perth. The Wildcats 35 lead the Melbourne Tigers 24. Full time in Newcastle, 98-74 in favour of the Brisbane Bullets. Tony Jensen 28 for Newcastle, Munt 21. Top scorers for Brisbane unavailable. Steve Woodbury had 19 at the half. This is Trehair firing again and draining three more. Well, he top scored for the Kings when they lost to the Magic earlier this year with 20. He is now up to 16 off the bench. It is unlikely to catch Kelsey Weems, who has 27 to lead the Kings. Kelly dishes to Mackinnon. Now Drimmick against Brad Williams. Fancies his chances. Hard to the hoop. Nielsen came up with the rebound. Doing the ball-carrying duties as well. Now Rosen. They leave him unattended again. Can't find the target. Nielsen's got it back again. Certainly hasn't stopped trying all night, Matt Nielsen. 9 points, 11 rebounds for him.
Not needed. I'm talking to him. Not needed,
Dodge. John Dorge all over Matty Nielsen there, and Eddie's saying he's going to go have a chat to Dorge. A little damage control. I don't think he had anything to say to him.
Cut it out!
It's been that type of a night.
I just said to you, hey, I talk to him, and then you go and have another go. Cut it out. Just play. Otherwise, both of you will be sitting out there. Finish, shut it up.
Well, 70 seconds away from the finish. Not a smart play to be upsetting the referees at the moment, but Matty Nielsen is rewarded for his persistence, now into double figures in scoring and rebounding. Final 60 seconds from Melbourne Park. Earlier this year, the Magic won by 27. Lead by 16 at the moment and would fancy their chances if they were to confront Sydney in the playoffs, I suspect, Steve.
If the Sydney Kings make it to the playoffs, it would look like they would just sneak in there and be on the Magic side on the draw.
Wheeler with a two-handed jab. His teams meet again in 4 weeks. Here's Trehair from downtown again. Couldn't get that to go. Wheeler comes up with a rebound. Kelly working against Trehair, pushes him over. Offensive foul on Mike Kelly, his fifth.
That's a pretty good D by Aaron Trehair. He was giving Mike Kelly some trouble as he kept turning him and then getting to the spot where he wanted to turn the corner on. I guess we have to look for something good about the Sydney Kings' performance here late in the fourth quarter. We're getting a lesson here on how to play and keep your head.
Trehair against Kelly. Pushes him to the floor. Another foul on Kelly. Adios for Mike, Kelly. Checks out of the game with 10 points, 3 rebounds, 6 assists. Does a lot of things that don't appear on the statistics, though. sits down next to Andrew Parkinson and the Bear, Tony Ronaldson, who will be prevented from a career high as Brian Gourgian rests him ahead of their next match, which will be against Illawarra on Wednesday. And the bad news for the rest of the league is that the Magic have six of their last 10 games here at home where they are undefeated. This will be 9-0 at home for the Magic, the only undefeated team in the league and their home court. 30 seconds remain. 16-point edge as Drimmick hands off to Mackinnon. Kings haven't won here for 2 years. And they're going to have to wait until next season to break that drought. This is Wheeler somehow juggling the ball up above his head and puts the finishing touches on. Trahair comes up with the ball after George couldn't reel it in, but now Wheeler's got it back, adding to his statistics, 21 points, 13 rebounds. On the buzzer, Nilsson will fire for the Sydney Kings, but it's all over. In fact, it was over a long way from the finish. The Magic have torn this game apart and come up with a very impressive display. The Southeast Melbourne Magic 126, the Sydney Kings 108 here on Fox. Kings outscore the Magic 35-28 in the final quarter, but the damage was done in term number three. For the Magic, after leading by 4 points at halftime, belted the Kings 41-20 behind 21 third quarter points from Tony Ronaldson, and he is our man of the match, not to anyone's surprise. There you see the numbers, and for the second consecutive night, the losing team comes up with a better shooting percentage from the field. But if you take a look at it, the Kings 78 shots, the Magic 96, and they had 18 extra shots by virtue of out-rebounding Sydney 46-39 and turning the ball over 12 times compared with Sydney's 19. But our man of the match is Tony Ronaldson. Here he is with Steve Carfina.
Tony, season high 32 points for you, but a great performance again from the Magic.
Yeah, I think we should be a little concerned with our first halves. They've been a bit disappointing the last two games, but our third quarter against Cameron, our third quarter tonight has been spectacular. And if we can put that together for even half a game, there's not going to be too many teams that can beat us.
Well, pretty good performance considering you virtually ran with seven players with John Dortch playing limited minutes because he's had that knee injury. But great performance against a team that ran very deep.
Yeah, I think that shows how even we are right from one to ten. If one person goes down, we can usually cover them. Not saying we won't miss the person that goes down, but we can usually cover them with some other way. We're not going to push the ball up like we usually do with C and try and get our running game going with Mike running the point. So it's just a testament to our team and how deep we go.
Did you anticipate the game to be so physical? It looked pretty physical from the side.
Well, I remember we played against Sydney the first game that Evans Burns comes out here, and he's a big, strong boy, and it's good fun having a battle. I think he's a great player, and I think everyone likes to see a little bit of banging down low, and I think it's good for the game.
Are you guys worried about the Kings coming into this one, especially with just seven players?
Yeah, I think you've always got to be wary of a team that's got some great shooters like Shane Heal and some great inside presence like Evers and Bruce and some young kids like Matt and Scott McGregor. And I don't think you can take anything lightly in this league, but they've been playing pretty well, a lot better than they did at the start of the season, so we knew we had to be wary and ready to go.
We look like you guys really took their three-point game away. They hit three-point shots, but it was after the game was over. Was that something you were looking to do beforehand?
Yeah, I think they're such a perimeter-orientated team that you've really got to try and shut down that. And get. Our philosophy was tonight to be, if we're going to get beaten by big. And I think we did a good job of shutting both down.
Well, congratulations on a great individual performance and team performance.
Thanks a lot, Steve. Thank you.
Tony Ronaldson, member of the Australian squad for the World Championships. He'll be there. Don't worry about that. And next Friday night, we will be back here at Melbourne Park as the Tigers, the reigning champs, play host to the Townsville Suns. Just check your local guides for telecast times. But it was all one-way traffic here in the second half, and the Southeast Melbourne Magic are now 17-3 on the season and undefeated at home as they beat the Sydney Kings by 18 points, 126-108. On behalf of all the team, including Steve Carfino, this is John Casey saying farewell from Melbourne.
This has been a Fox Sports production.